I'm Dan Benhart, Product Support Specialist with Mitutoyo America Corporation. In this video, we'll discuss the use of a dial caliper. With a lint-free cloth, wipe any dust off of the caliper. Place a piece of paper between the measuring faces and lightly close them. Without opening the jaws, pull the piece of paper out from between them. This will ensure that both faces are free from dust and oil. Next, perform a quick check on the parallelism of the outside jaws. Do this by holding the caliper up to a nearby light source with the measuring faces parallel and in line with your eyes and the light. You should not be able to see any light between the jaws. If you do, there may be contamination on them. If this is the case, re-clean the jaws with a piece of paper again. And if the light still shines through, there is likely damage to the caliper or a burr on the jaws, and it will need to be repaired. If the outside jaws are okay, check the inside measuring jaws if present. There should be a small amount of light shining through them, and the edges should be clean and free from burrs. Finally, check that the sliding jaw moves smoothly over the length of the beam. If it does, your caliper is ready for use. For maximum accuracy, keep the workpiece as close as possible to the beam of the caliper. Failure to do this causes the measuring force to be applied at the ends of the jaws where the most flex occurs. In some cases, the ends of the jaws are the only parts which can reach the feature that needs to be measured. If this happens, take great care not to apply excessive force, as this will cause the flexing we just discussed. Before any measurement, check that the dial reads zero. If it is off, loosen the bezel clamp and rotate the bezel so that the zero lines up with the hand. To measure with a caliper, simply bring the measuring faces into contact with the workpiece. Make sure that the faces are parallel to the feature by sweeping in all directions to find the minimum value for external features and the maximum value for internal features. Calipers can also be used for step measurements. This is done using the step measuring faces at the end of the caliper, located at the end nearest the jaws. Simply set the face of the sliding jaw on the upper step and slide the other face down, again looking for the minimum measurement once both faces are in contact. Lastly, if your caliper is equipped with a depth bar, you can use it as a depth gauge. The depth bar can be seen on the backside of the caliper and is attached to the sliding jaw. To use the depth bar, place the beam at the top of the feature which you want to measure the depth of. Then move the sliding jaw down until the end of the depth bar comes into contact with the bottom of the feature. As with the step measurement, you're looking for the minimum reading once both measuring faces are in contact with the workpiece.